Okay, hi traders, here's a new video. First of all, the risk warning, your invested capital may be at risk. Don't trade with money you cannot afford to lose. And this video is not investment advice. So this video is another deep explanation video about another few candlestick patterns. I have to discuss them before I'm going to start with the Forex stuff. And this candlestick patterns, which I'm describing in this video, are the three inside up and the three inside down, yes? And that are candlestick pattern based on those one which we know already, which I have explained already. But first of all, I have to notice and to recommend to any of you my ebook. Get this ebook, it's for free. You find the link in the description. This ebook contains the most important candlestick patterns, yes, chart pattern, binary option, turbo trading concepts. But those concepts can be applied also to forex and digital options. So get this ebook, it's for free. You find the link in the description. And I can only recommend to anybody of you to watch all my videos about those kind of stuff, and in particularly about this kind here, where I have discussed the high probability trading setups, all those reversal patterns which I'm naming, yes, and I'm telling you in my ebook, that are almost the initial of some kind of those things here, yes, this one here or this here below, and that is looking like a program flow chart, yes, and you see we have an uptrend, then we get a reversal pattern, those reversal pattern which I'm explaining in my videos, in the last videos in my ebook, and then we wait for a continuation pattern to show us that the trend will continue to go down, yes, in this example, for example, or for a pullback, which is also a sign that the trend will continue to go down, the major trend here, that is a sign for the major trend, till we get again a reversal, and then we get here some kind of cycle. So, and all those stuff is based on the four keys, the key level, the trend, the candlestick pattern, and the rejection, yes. So watch this video, it's important. And then watch also the videos about the Bollinger Band and the EMA. Here we have all kinds of types of Bollinger Band and what kind of trading setups you gonna trade on those kind of things. Watch this video, it's important. It's a playlist, it's called How to Use Indicators. I have done this playlist. There are two videos about two deep explanation videos about the Bollinger Band and two videos about live chart, yes, where I showed you those things of in the live chart. So let me see, and that was the most important thing here. And now we are getting to the candlestick pattern, to the three inside down and three inside up. So, and I have done this cheat here, yes, it's here, three inside up and three inside down. And because I do always, first of all, the uptrend and then the downtrend, I have to get them here. So let's see, the three inside up and three inside down are based on the Bahrami, yes, on the bullish and bearish Harami, yes. So let me see, I will copy them. So I will remove this kind of scenario here, yes, but it could be also done with the, but we can do this in some other place. We will do this in some other place. Let me see if I can show you this. So it's based, the basic, the start of this candlestick pattern, yes, is the Harami. So we have here the inside, three inside, right? Because it's a three bar candlestick, yes? It's a three bar candlestick. So it's the three inside down, yes? Down, let me see. Yes, I have to write this down. So this is a three inside down. It's that one which occurs in an uptrend. And that's the reason why it's a three inside down, because there are three candlesticks and then it goes down, yes? And that is the name, three inside down, yes? And let me, and here we have then the three inside up. Yes, we have three candlesticks, something like the evening star and the morning star, yes? Three inside up. Yes, you see we have a gap up, and so you can remember it. It's something like a bridge to remember, yes? So let me see, three inside up, that is three inside up. I will do this maybe in this case because I the Harami cross, yes? The Harami cross is also important, so I will probably doing it in some other type here. So I will move this all up, yes? Oh wait, I will move this all down, Yes, I will move this or copy. I will move this completely. And then I will move this one here up. Yes, so I have space here above, so three inside up. So I will do this here. So three inside up, and then put them here, yes. So, and I will do them those two here, maybe in this kind here. Run across, that should be clear. I will move this one and this one. So, and I will remove them two here. Yes, so, and now I'm going to show you how it looks like. So, the three inside up is now, I have to change this one here. So, I will make a little bit space. We have the Harami, which is showing us already, yes, that the trend has finished. Yes, the Harami is already a signal, it's not an entry point, yes. It's a signal that there could be now a reversal coming up, yes. And after this Harami, we get another bearish candle, yes. And important here is that the next bearish candle closes, yes, below the previous candle, yes. And the previous candle is this candle here, yes. That means we enter into a put below this candle here, yes, here at this level, after a rejection, copy, or from the support and resistance area, yes, which could be everywhere, yes, or a rejection from the wick or from the body, from the first of these three bars, yes, that means from this green candle here, yes. So, and that is how it looks like. You have a Harami, and you can enter after the next candle, yes, because it's the same like the evening star. If you have the evening star, the next candle after the evening star is almost also a put, yes. It's the same thing like the morning star. The next candle after a morning star is mostly also a call, yes, because that are those things which are initiating a trend, yes, and that's the reason why you can enter. I will do this a little bit greater, yes, so you understand this, that there will be mostly a huge candle. So, and that is already, yes, you enter here on the wick, yes, or on the real body of the first candle before the gap, before this baby here. This was the belly, yes, the belly of this mother candle here, and that was what the Harami is, the pregnant, yes, or the baby child or something like this, yes. You have to imagine that this was a Harami, yes, and then after this Harami you get this kind of candle and you enter on the rejection, yes, from this level. Let me draw here some, maybe also the support and resistance area could be here in between, yes. So something like this maybe, I don't know, could be something like this. So you can also wait for a rejection from the support area if you are more conservative, yes. So you enter here on the rejection from the support and resistance area. So I will do, but I would recommend to do this only from the here or from here. Yes, if price comes back to this price, to this level, or you enter here on this one here, where the from the first candle of this rebar candle. So, and that is, yes, until you enter, if you see a rejection, and that is a reversal pattern, or you wait till you get a candlestick pattern which confirms that the downtrend will continue and you go in a trend continuation. Yes, that is how you can trade the three inside down. So, and I will show you here three inside down. That is there are also three inside downs here when I'm doing this. Yes, and it has not to be. It can be also happen here with a gap up, yes. It's not only necessary that it's closed immediately. The next candle here, the next candle after this, yes, is mostly a red candle, yes, because this gap, this three inside down will initiate a reversal, yes, and that is the thing what's the important thing at this. So we have here this kind of scenario. Let me put this in this case. So, and or also this is also possible. Yes, that are also, because you know the Harami could be also a Harami cross, like this one, for example, yes. And then it looks maybe something like this. Yes, that are all three inside, two different types of three inside down. Yes, only once with a Harami cross and once without Harami cross. Yes. So let me see. I will put this three inside down, so you have to, because you know I cannot draw them in all particularly. Yes, because they can be really in all kind of forms. Important is only the relation, yes, between those candlesticks, and that is what I'm trying to show you here. So okay, that are the three inside down, and the same is valid here for the for this one here, for example. Let me remove this here. That is a three inside up. And there are also some candlesticks which I have to explain to, which don't have the opposite, yes, the other side, the yin and yang. Yes, this is a yin and this is a yang. Yes, but there are candlestick patterns which are working only bearish trends. Yes, and that I will show you also. So I have to remove, first of all, this line here. This line is disturbing. And it's doing only disturbing. So I have to remove this. I will put them here above so that it looks similar. So, and then I show you this. So the three, I will move also here this kind of support and resistance area to make this a little bit better. So for example here, yes. So this is a support and resistance area, support area. And then we get here another bullish candle. Yes, we get another bullish candle, and here it's important again. This candle has to close above the level of the first candle of the three candles here. Yes, so this is what's important here. So this candle, and then you wait on the next candle on a rejection from this level or from the support and resistance area if it's closer, yes, if it's close there. But mostly it's probably from this first candle of the three, because this candle has to close above this. So the distance to the support and resistance area should be too far away and not so good. But you don't know what can happen. It could be also that this is only a doji and that will be only a small candle. Then there could be that the support and resistance area is closer to this, and then you can trade it also. So I'm showing you the all those kind of things which can be happening, yes, but the market can do everything, and so you have to be creative and to apply also a little bit your common sense, yes, to understand that it could be in all different. I will show you those things then also in live trading when I'm doing those kind of things, so candlestick patterns, and when those candlestick patterns appear, yes. And it's only important that you know that this kind of pattern exists, yes, and what this kind of pattern means, yes. That is what I'm trying to show you here and what I try to explain, yes. That you know, I see a Harami, for example, yes. And then you trade this Harami, yes. And you can trade also the following candle, yes, because if you have a reversal, a good reversal happening, you can trade also the next candle too, yes, because you know it has established. This is what I'm trying to explain you with this one here. For example, this kind of three inside up and a three inside down can be applied easily to this concept here, which I have explained. Let me show you this here. So instead of this kind of engulfing candle, you can have here also a Harami, a bearish Harami, or you can have here an inside down, yes, or here you can have an inside up, yes. You know, those candlestick pattern, reversal candlestick pattern, can be applied in this kind of model, yes, of this kind of program flow chart at any point. And that is what I'm trying to teach you, because mostly those kind of candlestick patterns doesn't unfold immediately. So you have to be careful, you have to stick to the rules, yes, that you have to wait for a rejection from some key level, from the previous candles or from the first candle of this candlestick, this multiple or three bar candlestick, and then obviously or from the support and resistance, because you cannot enter immediately, because it could be at any time, so always some kind of retracement. So I think that was the three inside down and three inside up pattern. It's not so complicated if you understood the Harami. This is also easy to understand, because it's based on the Harami, and the following candle is then this what's about. So I would say that was enough. If you like this video, do like. If you didn't subscribe, subscribe. And if you have something to say, drop me a line in the comment section. So I would say stay safe and bye bye.